The doctor's right, Mum.
About what?
Faith. You've got to have a bit of faith in yourself. You can't expect me to have it all.
Oh, come on, Stevens. We haven't got much time.
All right, all right. What makes you so sure this is going to work?
Because I planned it. It'll turn the tables on Donovan, and if I play my cards right, it'll make Morris and Powell look like a couple of bungling idiots.
What is wrong with this bloody place? Is Joan all right? I mean, they didn't try to kill her or anything.
Look, she's fine. She's very wet and out for blood, but fine.
Oh, thank God for that. I don't think I could bear the police crawling all over the place again. Where is she now?
Oh, getting changed.
Oh, damn, that woman. She has been nothing but trouble since she's been here.
You'd think the department had put two and two together by now.
Right, what's happening? You found the keys?
Just a minute. I need a few answers first.
We haven't got time. Look, the longer we wait, the more
chance. Time. Now. Did you...
Mrs. Powell, a set of keys have been stolen. Now, do you realise what that means?
Ferguson, just in case you have forgotten, I am the deputy governor here, and like it or not, I am sitting in the chair at the moment, so we will do it my way. Firstly, are you all right?
Perfectly.
Good. Just in case, you'd better be checked by the doctor, though.
Mrs. Powell, do you mind if I make a suggestion?
What?
I've just been attacked, tied up, and placed under a running cold shower. Now, I realise this places you in a very delicate situation.
There's absolutely no need for that.
But do you think we could just ask Donovan for the keys? Nicely, of course.
That is what I wanted to ask you about. You see, Donovan left for the hospital quite some time
ago. Donovan did it. I heard her voice. Now, are you going to do something about it, or do I go straight to the minister?
Now, what the hell's taken so long here?
I know, it's awful, isn't it? What's that dreadful smell? It's just like a hospital.
Well, in case you hadn't noticed, Pixie, this is a hospital.
Oh, I know that, but why do they all smell the same? It's dreadful.
Disinfectant, dear. Mm. Now, will you two stop worrying and settle down?
Oh, how can we, Minnie? Something awful has happened to Lizzie. It must have, otherwise they would have let us see her by now.
Honestly, Pixie, you heard what the doctor said. She's out of intensive care, so that means she's out of danger.
Well, if you're so sure of that, how come you're jumpy, too?
I'm sorry. Yes, I am. Snappy, aren't I?
You're still worried about the keys?
Yes. If Ferguson's forced to admit that she's lost them, there'll be a cell search, won't there?
You can count on it.
That's what I thought. If that happens, we've had it.
Not necessarily, you know. You could say that someone had planted those keys in your cell.
No.
You could get away with just loss of privileges.
I'm not worried about that. I just don't want our little campaign ruined, that's all. Our Miss Ferguson has led a charmed life so far. Be nice to put a stop to it, don't you think?
You can say that again, kid.
God knows what we've done with the money. Now,
you haven't had enough time. You can sign off and go home, or you can shut up and help with the self search.
Oh, I think I'd better help, don't you, Mrs. Powell? I wouldn't like to think it wasn't done properly. I'll take Donovan's.
No, you won't. Will you do it, please, ma'am?
Right. What the hell's that supposed to mean?
You're claiming she took the keys from you, aren't you?
So?
Well, as fantastic as this may seem, she might accuse you of planting them in her cell.
What are you doing here, Stevens?
I'm just on my way back to the laundry, Miss Ferguson.
Well, get on with it.
Nothing wrong, is there? You look as if you lost something.
Get to work.
Mrs. Powell?
Well, now, you'll have to believe me, won't you?
Yes. Very careless of Donovan, though. This is the first place I looked.
Get moving, Stevens. Yes, I agree, but we can't ignore the evidence, can we?
Of course not. All we've got to worry about now is how many copies they've made. They've certainly had long enough.
All right, continue with the search, but for God's sake, keep it low-key. We'll have a riot on our hands. No, that isn't my decision. It's the department's.
Thank you.
going to do, Jude? She looks dreadful.
She's alive. That's all that matters.
I heard the doctor say she'd made an incredible recovery. She's an amazing old lady.
You're no spring chicken yourself, Min Donovan, so watch your language.
You old faker, you. We thought you were asleep.
How are you feeling, dear?
Not bad. I'd feel a lot better if they'd changed channels, though. Gets very boring watching your old ticker bouncing up and down on that thing.
Well, you just be grateful it's still bouncing, huh?
No, we're awfully worried about you, Lizzie, but, well, I feel much better now that I've seen you.
I thought you said that I looked dreadful.
Well, anyone would with all those tubes and things. You're not going to blow a fuse, are you?
Hey, where's Cassa? Why didn't she come and see me?
They'd only let three of us in. She'll be coming.
She's all right, isn't she? Bridges didn't hurt her, did he?
No, she's fine. She's just a bit upset, that's all.
Excuse me, ladies. I think we better do as the doctor said, don't you? One at a time?
Oh, yeah. We won't make any...
Come on, Pixie, that's right. We'll be back in a minute.
Yes, we'll see you soon.
Are you pretty?
Huh?
You scared the hell out of me, you know that? I thought you were a goner this time.
I thought I was myself, Jude. You know something? I didn't care.
Oh, come on.
No, it's true, love. I don't know what happened, but I suddenly felt safe. I felt free. And you know who I saw? All our old mates. Mum, Patty, Mouse, and Hayes. They were all there. And I talked to them. And then who do you reckon came along? Maxie. Little bugger. What the bloody hell are you doing here, she said. And when I told her what happened, she told me to bugger off and get back and look after you lot. Oh, don't be upset, love. I'm not. You want to know why? Because she's happy. They're all really, very...
Wonderful to see her again. Well, when do you think we could visit her again, Mrs. Radcliffe?
I thought you didn't like hospitals.
Well, I don't, but, well, they can be quite romantic at times, can't they?
How do you come to that conclusion?
Well, you only had to look at that nurse on the desk to see that she was so much in love with that doctor.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes, and that matron or sister or whatever she was, well, she was so jealous, which was crazy, really, because she was so much older than him. Oh, hi, Mrs. Morris.
Mason, Mrs. Radcliffe, will you take Donovan through to the governor's office, please? I'll take over here.
All right. Come along, Donovan.
Something wrong, Mrs. Morris?
Mrs. Powell will speak to you. Bag, please. Right. How was Lizzie?
Oh, she was wonderful and so brave. You should see all the awful things I had sticking into her.
You all right, Judy?
Oh, yeah, I'm great. Just said goodbye to an old friend I'll probably never see again. I couldn't be better.
Well, at least she's going home to her family. Better than coming back here.
Anything's better than coming back here.
Mrs. Powell, I've been guilty of many things in my life, but lying isn't one of them. And I repeat, I had no part in the attack on Miss Ferguson.
Won't work, Donovan. I heard your
voice. Thank you, Miss Ferguson. I'll handle this. Okay. Let's forget about the attack and concentrate on the keys.
You say they were found in my dormitory?
Under your mattress, to be precise.
Doesn't that seem rather silly?
Are you saying you didn't put them there?
If the person who stole the keys is responsible also for the attack on Miss Ferguson, then I must deny it.
Oh, well, looks like we'll just have to interview all the women.
Must you? I mean, well, the women have been through a lot lately and, Look, if I admit to it, then they won't have to be involved, will they?
Only those who helped you.
Help me do what, Mrs. Powell? took the keys, but that's all I did.
As far as I'm concerned, the two charges are connected. So it'll be up to the VJ to decide otherwise, not me.
And when will that be?
Sometime tomorrow. In the meantime, I am charging you with assaulting an officer and illegal possession of government property. Miss Ferguson will take you to solitary.
And Donovan?
Hello, hello. Where the bloody hell have you been? We've been running around like blue-ass flies.
I'm sorry, Phyllis, but they kept us waiting at the hospital.
It doesn't get the work done in here, does it? How's Lizzie?
I thought you'd never ask.
Oh, she's fine. And she sends her love to everybody.
You two timed it right, didn't you?
Yeah, well, it must be our lucky day, huh? Come on, love. You coming, Belinda?
Oh, I'll just finish folding the sheet. Bloody hell, we're never going to catch up.
Oh, why worry about it?
Someone's got to. Why, the freak breathing down our necks.
Lovely thought. Here, put some of this on.
What for?
It does amazing things to your hands. It's got an incredible ingredient.
So what? There's nothing wrong with my hands.
I said use it.
Okay. Jeez.
Forget it, Phyllis.
Well, what the hell was that all about?
Place is probably getting to her.
I'll take those from you if you like.
Yeah, thank you. Hello, Mum.
Hello, love. How long you been there?
Just arrived. How are you?
If I was any fitter, I'd be dangerous. Where are the girls?
What girls?
Jude. Oh, God. I must have dozed off while they were here. Three of my mates came to see me from Wentworth.
Well, it must have brightened you up a bit.
Yeah. It seemed really funny not seeing my mates every day. You get used to all your mates in a place like that.
Well, don't worry, Mum. They'll be able to visit you when they get out.
Yeah. You mean you wouldn't mind?
Oh, of course not. You've got to keep in touch with your mates, haven't you?
Oh, Arthur, you really are a very good person. You know that?
Listen, Mama, I've talked to the doctor and he said that you're coming along really well. He said you'll be home in no time at all.
Home? That'll take a bit of getting used to.
Not you, Mum. And we'll all be there to help you along. Now, is there anything that you want?
Yeah, there is something you could do for me if you wouldn't mind.
What's that?
I'd like to give all my mates a bit of a present, just something to remember me by.
What did you have in mind?
I don't know. Maybe a big case of whiskey.
I know how far that'd get.
I was hoping you'd be able to think of something.
Well, I'll give it some thought and I'll let you know what I come up with. And look, I'd better let you get some rest or the nurse will be kicking me out.
Rightio, love. Thank you for coming to see me. It's great seeing you without a screw leaning over your shoulder.
That's all behind us now, Mum. No more officers. Just good times.
Yeah. Just good times.
Okay, Donovan. There you are. Wall to wall cement. Oh, there's a lovely view from the window too. Bit high for you though, isn't it? Just have to take my word for it.
You're an extraordinary woman, Miss Ferguson. Why are you going to all this trouble?
Because you tried to make a fool of me, Donovan, and no one does that and gets away with it ever. And, Donovan, if you want anything, you're out of luck.
Sorry, dear. Old habits and all that. Sure you'll understand.
Donovan, when I give my evidence to the VJ, they are going to lock you away forever. I'm going to tip the bucket on you. The keys, the assault, the attempted hanging, the lot. Now, see if you can smile about that.
You, Jew? I'm worried about men. How'd you know I was upset?
You're practically splintering wood there.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm thinking with my hands, eh?
Hey, did you find her? No, it's really awful. I can't find her anywhere.
Yeah, well, we've really burned it this time, haven't we? She's probably been chucked in the pound.
Oh, what'll she get?
For pension keys? They'll throw the bloody book at her.
Oh, no, they wouldn't.
Of course they
would.
Social workers here?
Social worker?
Work release, remember?
Hey!
Oh, how wonderful! Oh, did you hear that, Judy? It's all happening!
Mrs. Morris, you couldn't tell us what happened to Min, could you?
No, I couldn't.
Come with me, please. Tell me about him,
Mrs. She's all right.
She's a screw, isn't she?
Well, at least some things are starting to happen, aren't they? I mean, we got work release for Pixie, we're going to have braille lessons for Belinda.
Remind me not to get too excited.
I thought you wanted the lessons.
I'll believe it when it happens.
You are a lady.
Well, there are a few people who wouldn't agree with you, but I like to think I am.
Miss Sweet, Pixie Mason.
Oh, sit down, Pixie.
Thank you. I'm sorry, Miss Sweet.
Linda.
Oh, Linda, I didn't mean to be rude.
Oh, that's all right. Now tell me, have you given any thought to your work release program?
Oh, yes, I've thought that all out. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. I do have one little problem, though.
Oh, what's that?
Well, would I have to supply my own uniform because I don't have very much money at the moment?
I'm sorry, what sort of uniform?
Oh, well, I've decided to be a nurse, thank you. At the Wentworth General, if possible. I saw
me,
a lovely
Pixie,
doctor
but,
there.
That's impossible.
Oh, well, any hospital would do, I suppose.
No, you don't understand. You're simply not qualified for that sort of position.
Well, what sort of thing could I do?
Well, as far as I can see, you've only had work experience as a waitress, is that correct?
Yes.
Well, I'm afraid you have to think of things more like, domestic help or waitressing.
Oh, well, couldn't you find me something a little bit more exciting?
I'm sorry, Pixie, but the only jobs I have here you could handle are as a kitchen hand, napkin folding, or a window cleaner.
Oh.
Sit down.
Why?
Because I want to talk to you. Come on, Pierce, don't be unfair. I owe you an apology. Remember the hand cream?
Hey, what the hell was that all about?
Some clown decided that my hands needed a cut and polish.
So you reckoned it was me?
Relax. I know it wasn't you. But I want you to do me a favour.
Yeah, well, why should I?
Because I know you like to stick with the strength, and I also know you like goodies. Lots of goodies.
I don't know.
Well, Phyllis, you've got nothing to lose. Let's face it, you've blown your parole, so you may as well be comfortable.
What do you want me to do?
Find out who it was. Simple as that. Deal?
Lola. Aren't you going to get something to eat?
No, I don't want to dirty your plate.
Why not?
Well, I'm applying for a job tomorrow.
And what's that got to do with it?
Well, everything. I'm applying to be a dishwasher. Isn't that awful?
Shocking. I'll never eat again.
Oh, listen, have you got your car back? Because Pat's picking me up in a couple of minutes if you need a lift.
Oh, thanks. Would you mind dropping me off at the garage?
See you at the gates.
Pauline, you look very tired. Are you all right?
No, I'm not tired. I'm flattened. I have just had another bout with those bloody reporters. They must think all their Christmases have come at once with this David Bridges thing.
Yes, well, it is very meaty stuff for them.
It may be for them, but I can do without it at the moment, especially with this Donovan thing hanging over our heads.
Do you really believe Minnie's done all these things Ferguson's claimed she has?
Of course I don't. But as usual, what can we do about it? Listen, you wouldn't care to be governor for a day, would you?
No, thanks. Pay's too low?
Oh. You learn who your friends are. Still, mustn't whinge. As bad as things are here, I still wouldn't want to swap with Anne at the moment.
No.
What's the matter, Stevens? Hand-sewing housework.
You want something?
No. Just a friendly little visit. Got yourself quite a nice setup now, haven't you? Eh? Since Hewitt left.
It'll do. Of course, it could be better.
Oh.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, Wentworth's without a top dog at the moment, right?
Now, if you're trying to find out about Donovan, she's in solitary.
Right. There's a vacancy and I'm the obvious candidate. The trouble is, I need merchandise to win the women over. And that's where you come in.
Why should I do that?
Well, if I was top dog, things could get a little, let's say, unpleasant for the acting governor. And who knows? The department might even stand her down and give you the job.
You know, Stevens, you've got an ugly little mind.
Wakey, wakey. Good morning. Sorry to have to wake you. Seems silly, doesn't it? But I'm just about to give you an injection to make you sleepy.
Wish you'd given me one last night.
Not good?
Terrible. I feel as if I haven't slept a wink.
You're not nervous, are you? Funny, we get a lot of nervous people in here. Can't imagine why. And Mr. Thomas really is the best in the business. So you just rest, and before you know what's happened, it'll all be over.
For better or worse.
Oh, now don't you go talking like that. Whatever happens has already been decided by your body, and nothing you feel is going to alter that. So why don't you just relax?
Yes. Why don't I?
Yes, but my skirt is too long, Judy.
No one will notice it. Must be a guy doing the interview, or you wouldn't even care.
Oh, I would. Oh, it doesn't matter anyway.
Hey, is this Pixie talking here? I thought you'd be designing your next wedding dress by now.
Look, I don't just marry anyone, you know. Well, they have to be special.
You're never with them long enough for it to matter.
Oh, don't be rude.
Hey, will you shut up? Cheer up, Pixie. I'll tell you what. Later on today, I'll help you take up that dress, huh?
Thanks.
You're welcome. Where's Cass? If she doesn't eat something soon, she's going to get sick.
Yes, well, that's why I'm feeling so down. I mean, no matter what I said, she still wouldn't come with me.
Yeah, well, what's that thing? Kermit in drag? Are you seen Min?
I'm sorry, love. I think they put her in the pound.
But I need her. She's my mate. Yeah, we all need something we haven't got.
Bobbie. Any.
Sorry. Do you want something to eat? I'll go get it for you.
No, not doing nothing. I just want him to bring Min back. Oh, you all know, don't you? You know they've taken her away and you're not telling me.
Hey, come on, let's settle down.
Yeah, that's what they've done. They've taken her to Barnhurst.
Oh, no, they haven't.
How do you know? You seen her? Yeah, that's what they've done. Shanghaied her to Barnhurst.
What's this? You're playing governor today.
Taking Mason for a job interview.
Next thing, they'll be having wine lists with their meals.
Look, unless they get some work experience, they'll keep coming back.
They'll keep coming back anyway.
Oh, surely you don't begrudge them a few favours after all they've been through with David Bridges.
Well, come on, we spend more time with him. Where are our favours?
None of us were murdered.
Those same animals nearly got me, though. But of course, that's different, isn't it? When's the governor's operation?
Sometime this morning. Are those for her?
No, they're not. They're for a friend.
Oh. Hell.
Have you got a minute?
That probably is all I have until that damn thing starts ringing again.
Well, I'll be quick and just give you the good bits.
I don't like the sound of that.
Well, for starters, Lizzie's on the mend. That visit from her friends did her the world of good.
Good, I'm pleased.
And Parker's physical wounds are healing, although she's still very unstable.
Yes, but that's to be expected, isn't it?
Yeah, but look,
Is Donovan in solitary? Parker's convinced she's been transferred and she's out of her mind with worry.
Yes, she is. Look, would it help Parker if she saw Donovan?
Most definitely. The way her mind is at the moment, anything would help.
Okay. I'll arrange a visit. Was that the bad news?
No. You probably don't know, but my father's been ill recently, and I've just heard from the family in Perth. He's taken a turn for the worse.
Oh, Scott, I'm sorry. Well, of course, you've got to go. Take as much leave as you need.
Thanks. But that's not all the bad news. I've decided to hand in my resignation. Look, Petra and I have been thinking about it for a long time. She's found it very difficult to adjust. Most of our friends know she was in here, and, well, what with the publicity surrounding the murders, they're being a little insensitive. It doesn't make it any easier for her.
No, it wouldn't.
So we'd figured that when we go to Perth, it'll be a one-way trip.
You want to leave immediately?
Is that possible?
Oh. Well, I don't know what the department will think about it, but... Oh, I suppose there's not much they can say if you've already gone, is there?
Thanks. We really appreciate it. I just hope you can come up with a replacement soon.
Well, the department's being pretty generous at the moment in compensation for the David Bridges disaster. We'll go for a doctor while they're in a good mood. It's going to be hard to replace you, though.
Thanks. Well, I better get cracking.
Good luck. Oh, here we go again.
I'll leave you to it.
Bye. Yes. Put him through. Yes, that's right. No, I'm sorry. You were given a statement yesterday. That's all we're going to say. Goodbye.
Hey, Chara. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, the skirt looks fine, but now your petticoat's hanging down.
Oh, but
down.
It's supposed to, Judy. That's a fashion nowadays.
Stupid. There you are, Mason. I'll be looking everywhere for you.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris. I had to have my skirt taken off. Thank you.
So how's Mrs. Reynolds?
I don't know. She's in hospital.
Oh, poor Mrs. Reynolds.
But something serious, is it?
I don't know. Hope not.
Oh, well, we should take her some flowers or something. We could make her a beautiful card, couldn't we?
That's a good idea, Pixie.
And I could take it to her while I'm out of my work release.
Oh, we haven't time now. We're running late.
Oh, heavens, why am I hanging around here for?
Look, if you do make her a card, I'll make sure she gets it.
Well, thank you very much. Good luck. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, hell. I forgot to ask her what was happening with Minnie.
Yeah, she's so easily forgotten, isn't she? I haven't missed her at all.
Oh, shut up, Sonia. There's enough hot air in here already.
Look, if top dogs want to keep barking, they shouldn't put themselves out of action. It's hard keeping things in order if they lock themselves up in the pound.
And what do you know about it?
Your schoolmates would have kept you informed, Bryant. Tut, tut. You used to be so close. Well, girls, I think it's time for a new top dog. Donovan seems to be leading you astray right, left and centre lately.
Throwing a few chocolates around isn't going to make you a top dog, Sonia. We've been bitten by you too many times in the past.
You'll see. There's more where they came from.
No harm in taking a chocolate.
Oh, sure.
Exactly what I say, Bobby. For later.
Welcome back.
You
feeling okay?
Bit nauseated.
That'll go away soon.
What happened? Was it all right?
We'll let Mr. Thomas talk to you about that. Speak of the devil. Now, here's your buzzer. Just press it if you need anything. And you look after yourself.
Mrs. Reynolds, how are you feeling?
My right arm feels numb.
That's normal. Nothing to worry about.
But I can't feel my right side. What happened? What did you find?
Mrs. Reynolds, we've had to remove your right breast. I'm sorry, but it was necessary.
Oh, it's a wonderful day. Isn't it a wonderful day, Mrs. Morris?
Yes, Pixie.
Do you think later we could go for a cup of coffee? coffee? A real coffee?
Well, we really haven't got much time.
Oh, please.
All right, we'll see.
Oh, good. One with all the fluff on top.
All right, Pixie, all right.
We've never had one of those
for
so long.
First, we'll go through the interview.
Oh, that's a nice little dress shop.
Yes.
We couldn't go anywhere.
Off you go. No, we're going straight ahead.
You looking for me?
No, I was just on my rounds and I thought I might pop in and say goodbye. See if I could perhaps give you a hand to clean up.
No, it's all been done.
Oh, sorry to hear about your father.
Thanks. Oh, look, there is something you can do for me. Mrs. Powell wasn't in her office before. I wonder if you could just mind giving her the hospital keys for me.
Sure.
Well, I suppose it's goodbye, Wentworth. I'll miss it, no? Enjoy it, Miss Ferguson.
Of course, Ludmilla. Tomorrow evening. Now, look, I can't, not now. I'm flat as a tack. I've got a customer. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Yes, madam, can I help you?
Has there been a young lady in here?
Oh, there've been many. We're a very successful boutique. Do you mean someone in particular?
Oh, she's about 25. She's got big green eyes, short blonde hair. She's wearing a pink shirt and a pink fluffy top.
No, mind you, I've been very busy. She might have popped in and out while I wasn't looking.
Oh, thanks anyway. If she'd seen this place, she'd still be here.
Office, Powell speaking.
Colleen, I've lost Pixie. There was some confusion at the lifts. I just don't know where she is.
Oh. Do you expect me to tell the minister that? Look, I don't care, Meg. Just find her. Listen, I won't call the police yet, but for God's sake, just find her, all right? Now, Mason's gone. The department will have my head on a tray.
But Mason doesn't seem the type to want to escape, Mrs. Powell.
There's a type?
Sorry, Mrs. Powell. Well, is there anything I can do?
Oh, no, look, I'm sorry. Just get these back to Mrs. O'Regan, will you? I don't want her in here as well.
G'day.
Look what I got. I reckon it ought to have been a cat. They got nine lives. Trap only got its tail.
Jeez, don't do that.
What?
Hurt him like that.
Doesn't make no difference. It's going to be dead soon anyway. I'm off to give it diving lessons in the dunny.
Oh, no, don't, Bobbie.
What am I meant to do with it? Give it to Mrs. O'Regan? She'll probably stick it in tonight's tea.
No, I'll take him.
Suit yourself. Oh. Don't let the freak catch you with it. She'll know I gave it to you.
No, of course I won't let her see him. She'd take him away from me. Oh, isn't he lovely?
Oh, soft and warm. Yuck. Anyway, how do you know it's a boy?
I know. Mitchell, did you get rid of that mouse?
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Good. Well, Parker, you getting used to being without Donovan? Never mind. Plenty of time yet.
Rotten bloody bitch. Oh, what do you mean by that? Isn't Min never coming back? Yeah, of course she is. Freak's only trying to upset you, that's all. Hey, bet there'd be one freak if she knew where that mouse was. Well, mouse, looks like life number three's coming up. Definitely should have been a cat. See ya.
Where? Well, little mouse. Looks like you and me are gonna be mates, eh?
I mean, I want her as top dog.
But that's a pretty good way of putting her there, isn't it?
Crap. Look, I can take what she's willing to hand out. Doesn't mean I owe her anything.
You know, you haven't learned anything since you've been in here, Bobbie. You're really dumb, you know.
Shut up, will you? All I get from you is whinge. I'm sick of it.
Stevens. So, they like chocolates, do they?
Yes. Shouldn't take too much persuasion at all.
Oh, no, don't get carried away, Stevens. We have to plan this very carefully if we're to get rid of all the opposition. You see, it won't take too much to spark those women off at the moment. And if that were to happen, I think the department would have to very seriously consider Powell's ability as acting governor.
Good. That means we'd have Mrs. Morris.
Oh, not necessarily. It would depend on the incident, wouldn't it, Stevens?
I see.
Yeah, I knew you would. I'll leave you to it.
Hello.
Hi. From me? From Wally.
They're beautiful.
So are you. He's outside. He wants very much to say hello.
I've told him, Paul, I can't.
He loves you, Mum. We both do.
Thanks for being here.
Can I tell him to come in?
No. Say thank you, but no.
Oh, I'll give these back to the nurse. Back in a minute. Sorry, mate.
Your mum's a stubborn woman. I love her very much.
I know.
You look after her?
Yeah.
She's going to need you around for a while. A lot of patience. A lot of understanding.
I'll be there, mate.
I'm not going to give up. You tell her that.
I'll tell her.
Hello? Hello? Can I get in, please?
You a visitor?
No.
ID, please.
What's an ID?
Well, if you haven't got one, then you can't get in.
Oh, but I live here.
You mean you're a prisoner?
Well, there's no need to be insulting about it. Some of my best friends are prisoners. What's your name?
Trevor Kelly.
Well, Mr. Kelly, do you think I'd be wanting to get in here if I didn't live here? Please, ring Mrs. Powell. She'll tell you it's all right. Well, just tell her Pixie's back.
Please.
You sure? Take the tray in and no talking to the prisoner.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Just a minute, Miss Ferguson. Mrs. Powell's decided it might help Parker to see Donovan, so we've been instructed to give her the meal.
Pampering prisoners in solitary now, are they?
I don't think so.
Give her the tray. Benefit.
Say hello for me.
That's enough, Shaw. Get back to work. Maybe we should put you in the next cell, Parker. You could tap out messages all day.
All right, in you go, and don't take too long.
Miss Barfield.
Ah,
yes, love.
Jeez, Min, I thought they'd taken you away forever.
You wouldn't do that, you silly duffer, not just for pinching keys.
Hey, Min, look. Hey, how about that, eh?
Oh.
He's me little friend.
He's lovely, dear. Yeah.
Isn't he sweet, eh? All right, Parker, it's time to go.
Now, don't worry about me. I'll be out of here soon. You take care of yourself and your little friend.
Okay, Min. Hey, I hope you like your tea. See you soon, Min.
And she thought I looked so wonderful in it that she bought it. Just like that. And she didn't even ask me if I was selling it, so I had to tell the lady in the shop, and she was so pleased with me.
Well, what was Mrs. Morris doing all this time?
Having a mental hernia.
It had beautiful white lace up around the bust and then white lace up to the neck and a little ruff. And then at the waist it had a lovely V and a gorgeous long train.
That sounds stunning. Hey, did they give you any money for selling it?
Oh, they offered me a job.
They what?
Well, only part time.
Well, when do you start?
Next week. And the veils and the headdresses. There was one veil that had, well, it was almost all orange
Pixie.
Blossom. Well, not real orange blossom, but it was beautifully
Pixie,
done.
Did you tell them about yourself?
Well, what do you mean?
Well, did you tell them you're in prison?
No. Well, do you think it would matter?
Please, someone, please.
Evening, Donovan.
Please, I need a doctor.
Oh, the doctor's gone, Donovan. Hours ago. Permanently. Goodness me, don't tell me someone spiked your food.
Please.
You really should be more careful what you eat. Remember that next time.
Give me roses, I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare. When morning comes around.